예, 지금 오늘 그 레이브 미드업이 있어서 이렇게 찾아왔거든요.
반 박수.
예, 각자 자기 소개 부탁드리겠습니다.
Can you guys first introduce yourself, starting with?
Yeah, sure. I'm Quan Lock, the CEO of BXB Exchange.
And I'm Tron Black, the lead developer for Raven Quick.
예, 두 분 그 프로젝트하고 지금 거래소가 어떤 식으로 만났는지 굉장히 예, 유저분들도 홀더분들도 많이 궁금하실 것 같은데 그 부분 간단하게 설명 가능하세요?
I think a lot of Dory's community members as well as Ravencoin holders are curious about how Ravencoin and BXB got to meet each other. Could you explain a little bit about that?
Sure. So we first met in Amsterdam, actually. I was like unknowingly presenting tap trading to Adam Bull at the time. And for us, it's really funny because like we always wanted to work with Raven. And so it was just like coincidence that Adam Bull was there and I was showing him like the product. For those people who don't know, tap trading is like the simplest, easiest, and fastest way to trade Bitcoin. And he was really impressed with the product and actually came back about three times, and then as brought more and more Raven community members with him. And I think this shows just like how unique the product is for the crypto world and finance world in general, because I really believe nothing truly exists like it. And so from that end, it kind of just grew. We got more closer with the Ravencoin liaison, and that's how the exchange listing kind of happened.
지금 방송에서 그 레이버 홀더들이 정말 많으면서 저한테 질문도 이렇게 좀 많이 들어왔던 게 그 저 새의 의미, 그 로고에 대한 의미하고 저 색상 어떻게 컨셉이 있고 어떤 의미를 지니고 있는지 그 부분 좀 간단하게 설명 안 할까요?
So a lot of the community members have been constantly asking Dory, what's the meaning behind the logo of Ravencoin and why did you go with those colors?
Why a
bird? Is there a specific reason behind
this? I wish I had a better answer for you. That was Bruce Fenton, the former executive director of the Bitcoin Foundation, came up with the logo and the brand and the name. And so when I first kind of met him and we were working on the project that came with it, so that was where it started. I wish I had an origin story for that, but I don't. So.
예, 전 세계에서 그 레이븐 홀더가 한국에서 제일 많다고 그렇게 알고 있거든요. 그런 특별한 이유가 있을까요? 그리고 그 한국 유저 분들의 이렇게 그 인기가 많은 거에 대해서 어떻게 생각하시는지.
So what we've heard is that in the whole world, it seems like the most Ravencoin holders are in Korea. How does that make you feel? Did you know about that? And is there anything that you'd like to say to them?
That's awesome. and I didn't know about it until this event. And it's becoming more and more obvious with the presence here at this event. A full theater and a waiting list, it's just amazing. It surprised me.
Do you have any guesses as to why it would be popular in Korea?
I don't know.
I don't know.
왜 레이븐
좋아하세요?
레이븐
추천했잖아요. 네, 제가 전에 추천을 드렸어요.
Yeah, Dory actually.
That's
also
you're
recommend.
The man.
Yeah, I'm really shocked.
awesome, 그래서 지금 그 BXB하고 레이븐을 통해서 커뮤니티가 그 서로 이렇게 뭐 상장이나 지금 이런 걸 하면서 서로 어떤 점이 이득이 있을까요? BXB하고 레이븐.
So as Ravencoin has become listed on BXB exchange, particularly the futures and options as well as the coin. What do you see as the benefit for Ravencoin holders on BXB exchange? And also, vice versa, what is the benefit for the BXB community members by having Ravencoin?
Sure. I'd say for the benefit for Raven holders is that they get to trade derivative products. We're the first to list options trading for them, and one of the only exchanges that can do futures trading. Because future trading, we believe it's like quite complex, and not many exchanges are able to do it. I'd say over 99% only rely on spot trading. But for us, we come from a more traditional finance background with over 20 years in the derivative markets. Actually, our CTO is a former chief architect of the Shanghai Futures Exchange. So we've built a great system, and we're used to trading derivatives. So when people come to BXB Exchange, they can experience a very fluid and very fair trading environment. And that's, for Raven holders, I think that's, especially those who like to trade derivatives, or even spot, that's very important, time price priority, and very stable system. And for our community members, we believe Raven to be a very stable digital financial asset, and we're very focused on retail traders. So we believe that having a stable, tangible product or investment is very crucial. So that's what BXB communities can get out of Raven. And also, if they want to start their own blockchain products, they can do so on Raven, which is very interesting.
그 레이븐 이렇게 이야기를 하면서 그 일반 트레이더들이 그 뭐 가격이 올라가고 내려가는 거 이런 거에 대해서 트레이더들에서 상당히 공포감을 많이 느끼는데 이런 부분을 갖다 어느 정도 해소할 수 있는 부분이 있다고 들었는데 뭐 어떤 부분이 있을까요?
So for crypto traders, the greatest fear is kind of the volatility of the altcoin market. Could you speak a little bit to how kind of Raven Coin doesn't have those same restrictions or dangers, and why is that?
Well, I think Raven Coin, as well as any other, you know, does have volatility, but the options trading does help reduce volatility because if someone thinks that it's too high, they can kind of help level it out, and so it is a feature of options trading that it helps level volatility. So I would say it does have it, but options trading specifically from BXB helps remove some of it.
I think it's also very different. Like when we look at Raven's kind of price, like compared to other ones, we don't see this huge like pump and dump stuff. So it's really very cool. Yeah.
지금 그 레이븐 로드맵 상에 여러 가지 이제 코인이 나오는 걸로 알고 있는데 그 중에서 우리의 미래를 바꿀 만한 이런 게 이제 빨리 나올 수 있는 그런 것들이 있는지 그 부분에 대해서.
So according to what we hear, it sounds like there's a lot of awesome projects that are going to be developed on Raven. Are there any of these that you know of that might really transform not just blockchain, but the way that we interact with assets and crypto assets?
Yeah, so there are a lot of projects. I do get contacted by people that want to tokenize art, to tokenize real estate, to tokenize companies. There's laws in various jurisdictions that kind of restrict, you know, and you have to be careful about making sure you stay legal within the jurisdiction. But there's a lot of projects that want to tokenize, and Ravencoin's a great project to tokenize on for a couple of reasons. It's really easy. It's across all six platforms, meaning web, iOS, Android, Linux, Mac, Windows, and then it also has the ability to attach the token to a document, to IPFS, which is where you can store what does this token mean, which some of the other token platforms, specifically like ERC20, for example, doesn't have that feature and capability. So I think because of that, it's a great platform to tokenize anything. And then the ability to attach what that token means gives it kind of a leg up on some of the other platforms.
Sure.
지금 그 다른 거래소들도 그렇고 그 기관의 샌드박스 형태로 많은 자금을 갖다가 이제 유치시키는 이런 부분이 있는데 그 BXB 거래소에도 이런 플랫폼을 현재 개발하고 있는지 그 부분에 대해서.
So a lot of one trend we've seen with exchanges is that they're tending to go the sandbox route where they kind of incubate projects within the exchange. Does BXB have any plans to do this? What are your thoughts regarding it?
Sure. For us, we're more focused right now on providing people with a trading platform. So we're not very focused on more incubation projects. If a project wants to do an IEO, we can help and assist with that. But for our end, we have one mission, and that's making trading accessible to as many people as possible. So that's our main focus right now.
어쨌든 굉장히 중요한 질문인데 한국에 투자자들 엄청나게 많잖아요. 이분들은 항상 좋은 수익을 기대하는데 지금 레이븐 쪽에서는 어떤 식으로 수익을 가치를 많이 창출할 수 있을지 이윤을 어떻게 많이 만들 수 있을지 그런 부분에 대해서 설명해 줄 수 있을까요?
Perhaps the most important question for RavenCoin holders in Korea, especially with the biggest holder market being in Korea, is what's RavenCoin doing to kind of increase the give back and increase the value of RavenCoin for their holders in Korea?
Sure. So one thing that we do focus on is really just the code, and then there's a community kind of built around that. That's building the second tier tools and the, you know, so even the marketing and the awareness and things like that isn't done kind of from the core team that I'm working with. So that kind of gets built by the community. It's a little bit different than say the 2017 ICO where people were collecting lots of money and then kind of had that money to do kind of outbound marketing. We don't really have a marketing budget. So this is a kind of a grassroots get in early and then we're basically trying to build the core technology really sturdy and strong. And then as the ecosystem grows, we hope that, you know, it'll become more and more valuable.
지금 비트코인이 가격이 많이 낮으면서 예, 정말 그 펀더멘탈이 좋은 코인 같은 경우는 계속 사라고 이야기를 하고 있는데 예, 레이븐도 거기에 포함이 되거든요. 레이븐은 계속 사라고 유저 홀더들한테 이제 한국 그 투자자들한테 많이 얘기하는데 그 부분 어떻게 생각하시죠?
So as the price of Bitcoin is kind of faltering, Doridori is recommending his community members to buy very stable and dependable coins. RavenCoin is one of them. What do you think about that?
That's a great idea.
예, 이야기 들으셨어. 사시면 된대요. 예, 가격 오른다고 그렇게 말씀하셨고 지금 거래소 중에 지금 제일 핫한 곳이 BXB라고 저는 그렇게 개인적으로 생각하는데 앞으로 많은 지원도 있을 거라고 이렇게 예상하거든요. 지금 레이븐 코인에 대해서 BXB는 어떤 생각을 갖고 계신지.
So what we've heard is that BXB is one of the hottest exchanges coming out right now. Is there something in particular that you'd like to tell the community about RavenCoin and how BXB can really work together in the future?
I think working together would be for the derivative trading products and providing Raven holders with different types of trading assets. And then also, I think we're introducing or opening up a new market in the sense that with our tap trading is one of the most accessible, easy way to get into trading. So the more we bring in new people, the more we can recommend them strong projects like Raven to kind of invest in, and just like a hold. It's really like as trading gets more popular, they need more stable and more good, really good projects to invest in. That's what we can help do is bring people in and then show them like the good projects.
오늘 인터뷰 정말 이렇게 참여해주셔서 다시 한번 감사드리고 한국 유저분들한테 한마디씩만 짧게 부탁드릴게요.
Thank you so much for doing this interview with us. And if you could just say one thing to your Korean community members each, we can start with Tom.
All right. Well, thank you for having me first, and thank you for embracing RavenCoin and for being part of the community and part of this project.
Yeah, I'd just like to say thank you to the Korean community. It's been a really great, very fast-growing community for us at BXB Exchange, and I'd like to thank Tron for doing this live AMA session with us. So thank you so much to Korea.
Yeah, Dorina team, fighting!